Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mr. TARDIS, and welcome to a new edition of TV News. Ding, ding, da, ding, ding. I need a new theme. And I'm here today to talk about a show that was very close to my heart, and that was Robot Wars. It's something that I grew up with. I was 6 years old when Robot Wars started in 1998, when Jeremy Clarkson was hosting. And when Craig Chow started hosting, I continued to follow the series up until 2004. It changed to Channel 5 in 2003, where it had its final Series 7, and then it was gone for over a decade before BBC Two brought it back in 2016. You had Dara O'Brien and Angela Scanlon hosting. You had some of the original judges like Noel Sharkey, you had the commentator Jonathan Pierce. It was a really great revival. For those of you who don't know, Robot Wars is basically a UK show where teams from all across the UK gather together with their robotic creations of death and destruction and war and have them fight in a massive arena for robot glory. And on the surface, Robot Wars might just seem like a series where it's all destruction and carnage and chaos, and yes, that is a big drawing factor. It's one reason I was really drawn to it as a kid, but it's also a great show in terms of showing community spirit. I can't remember what season it was, but it was one of the finals of the original series where one of the robots was completely destroyed, but it still found its way into the final, so all of the other teams, all the other competitors came together to help to fix the robot in time for the finale. It was amazing TV. And with its revival in 2006, the BBC gave an extra emphasis in terms of STEM fields and getting children into science and engineering, which in my opinion is a really good use of the BBC license fee as well, to try and get people into engineering, to show them different career paths, to try and educate people about robotics, about the world. The robot judges, Noel Sharkey, Sethu Vijayakuma, and Lucy Rogers, they had great insight into robotics around the world, and it was really fascinating to watch, and kids were really into it as well. You had some kid teams and some school teams who came together in the arena in Glasgow where they filmed the series, and you had a massive studio audience. You had this great set as well where the battles took place. However, after three seasons, and what seemed to be three quite successful seasons, the BBC recently announced that Robot Wars was going to be cancelled. Last Friday, the Robot Wars UK Twitter account said, "Sad to confirm the BBC's decision to deactivate our house robots. A huge thank you to Dara and Angela, our brilliant judges Noel, Lucy and Sethu, all of the amazing teams, and most of all, you, for joining us on this amazing robot smashing adventure. Hashtag bring back Robot Wars, hashtag Robot Wars." And the BBC press office followed that up saying, "We are very proud of hashtag Robot Wars and would like to thank Mentorn Media, the presenters Dara O'Brien and Angela Scanlon, and all those involved in the last three series. However, in order to create room for new shows, it won't be returning to BBC Two." And the reaction to this online has been really encouraging, but still quite depressing. You see so many stories of people whose kids were really into Robot Wars and wanted to get into engineering, and now they can't watch it, and families gathering around the TV on a Sunday night to watch it, and now they're going to miss the series, and I'm sad as well, because it was really good television. And full disclosure, I am currently working freelance at the BBC, but I do not mind talking shit to my employers. In fact, I am actually wearing this very outfit while I'm recording this, because I'm away on work at the moment. I'm in a hotel room, I have a uniform, yada yada yada, but I do not mind talking shit about the BBC, because I've been doing quite a bit of research over the past few days trying to find out what went wrong here. Why was a series that was, by all intents and purposes, really, really well received by the fans, with a really great formula, suddenly cancelled? You could argue it was budget, but the very first series in 2016, that's probably where most of the budget went. You had to get the studio, you had to get the crew, you had to design the new format, you had to design the setting, rebuild the house robots and market it. That is where most of the budget goes. Once that set is built, once the formula is in place, future seasons don't cost as much. And I also know for a fact that they don't film the series for very long, and I know that because I actually tried to apply for a job working on it, but I couldn't do it because I was working on something else at the time, and Robot Wars was on my bucket list of shows to work on, and now I can't do it, damn it. They would only film for about 1 or 2 weeks in Glasgow, and then that's 6 weeks of entertainment on the BBC. It is a cost-effective show, in my opinion, and this is coming from someone whose job has sometimes literally been to balance the books on TV shows. I know that Robot Wars, in the grand scheme of things, is not a massively expensive show to make. So I searched high and I searched low. I tried to find out what people thought of the series and how it performed, but looking at all the outside factors, the BBC themselves kind of destroyed Robot Wars. I've been looking through the official BARB figures for all three seasons of Robot Wars, and there was definitely a decline, but when you looked at all the other factors, it was kind of apparent why that decline happened. When the series came back in July 2016, the viewing figures were pretty strong, averaging around 2 million viewers per episode. On BBC Two on a Sunday night, it had an 8 p.m. time slot. And it wasn't really competing against anything quite notable. You had Fake or Fortune on BBC One and really not all that much on the other channels, and it did quite well. The lowest performing episode of season one was actually the fourth episode. I do not have viewing figures for that because it dropped out of the top 30 because there was so much Olympics coverage that week and that kind of dominated the charts. But with series two, you see almost an instant drop off. It starts with 1.59 million before picking up slightly with 1.68 and then kind of dropping to the 1.4 region again. So relatively stable, but why was there that drop? Well, the time slot changed. For Series 2, the BBC moved Robot Wars from an 8 p.m. time slot to 7 p.m. It was on before Top Gear. However, it competed against, of all things, Country File. Now, for those of you who don't know, or maybe outside of the UK, Country File is a show that the BBC play almost every Sunday where they talk about rural UK culture and farming and animals and things like that. And then at the end of the episode, they talk about the weather for the next week. And while I'm sure many of you are thinking that sounds like the worst idea for TV ever, Country File is a massive show. In fact, barring any mitigating circumstances like Olympics coverage or a massive sporting or political event or something, Country File, without fail, will be in the top 10 TV shows for the UK of that week. It gets around 7 to 8, sometimes even 9 million viewers. It's a massive show, and its demographic is mainly with the elderly or some older people or people in the country, and also with a family audience, which goes right against Robot Wars. And if you're a kid who wants to watch Robot Wars on the TV at 7 p.m, guess what? You can't watch it because Grandma wants to know what the weather's going to be on Monday. So as a result, the viewing figures declined for Series 2, so when it was brought back for Series 3 in October 2017, it was moved to a different time slot, 8 p.m. which presumably was so it wouldn't clash with the Strictly Come Dancing results. And it fared quite decently. It got 1.33 million viewers. However, the next week we see another decline, 1.17 million. And the reason for that is the next five episodes of Robot Wars Series 2 went up against Blue Planet 2 on BBC One, also on at 8 p.m. And that episode of Blue Planet got 14 million viewers. Not only was it the most watched program on the BBC that night, or that week, or that month, it was the most viewed TV program of the entirety of 2017. And for the next episode, Blue Planet 2 Episode 2, that was the second most watched piece of TV for that year, and Episode 3 was the third most, and Episode 4th was the fourth most, and Episode 5th was the seventh most. I actually don't have viewing figures for Robot Wars Series 3 Episode 3 to 4 to 5 to 6 because it completely drops out of the BARB Top 30. Robot Wars is a factual, educational, pseudo-action show, which puts it literally in direct competition with Blue Planet 2 in terms of a demographic and viewership. But it couldn't move to 7 p.m. because Top Gear was there, and they don't want Top Gear competing against Blue Planet 2, and they don't want it post-Watershed, because Robot Wars post-Watershed doesn't quite work. Why not have it at a different time or a different day? Don't put it up against the most successful show of 2017 and then cancel it when it doesn't work out. And even if Robot Wars did just get over a million viewers for the episode, that's not even particularly bad considering the budget of the show. I also think one issue with the new reboot of Robot Wars is that BBC and BBC Worldwide haven't really pushed it outside of the TV shows. They released the series on DVD and Blu-ray, which, yes, they totally should have done that. However, what about the toys, the action figures, the remote-controlled cars, and all of that stuff, all the merchandising? When I was growing up, when I was younger, there were so many Robot Wars toys. I owned so many of them. I had a Sir Killalot, a Dead Metal, a Chaos 2, a Razor, a Panic Attack. I had all of these Robot Wars toys. They were in Toys R Us, and rest in peace, Toys R Us. I had a battle arena with little mini wind-up pullback toys. I had the books, and yes, they released one complete compendium and an official handbook for Robot Wars for the revived series, and that's it. Yeah, well done pushing the brand, BBC. Back in the day, there used to be like special DVDs, there was a PS2 game, there were some Game Boy Advanced games. Robot Wars has quite a dedicated following, and a following that wants these action figures, that wants these collectibles, but you didn't provide any of it for them. That's the additional revenue stream that, yes, Blue Planet 2 is a massive ratings juggernaut and will probably do well on home media, but you're not going to get a killer whale robot action figure, although I'd buy that in a heartbeat. So it seems that Robot Wars for the foreseeable future is not coming back, which is massively depressing because there's still more robots out there to be built, more metal out there to be smashed, more kids out there wanting inspiration to get into engineering but don't exactly want to build some supercomputer or something, they want to build something that can smash into other things. It's a great use of the BBC license fee. Let's just hope that it doesn't take another decade for Robot Wars to come back to TV screens. Hopefully, maybe a company like Netflix or Channel 5 or maybe even Channel 4 could pick it up as well. The arena's there, it's in Glasgow. The formula is there, just pick it up and make it work, just pass on the baton and you can start up where you left off. Actually put it in a decent, adequate time slot and actually push the merchandising for it. But anyway, that's my thoughts. That's just the rantings of a BBC freelance employee who loves Robot Wars. What do you folks think about Robot Wars getting cancelled? I know a lot of you were genuinely curious about what I thought about it, so these are my thoughts. Post them in the comments section below. Share this video around if you want people to know why Robot Wars got cancelled. And be sure to hit that subscribe button and that bell icon to get more TV news in the future. And I'll see you folks next time. Hey folks, thanks so much for watching this video, and oh my goodness, who are these names? Who are these awesome, really cool people? Well, they are my patrons. They help to keep the lights on here at Trooper Reviews. They get early access to some of my content and also including my podcast, the Film Brits podcast. They also get to be a part of the podcast by asking questions and submitting topics and such. So if you would like to help support the content and also get involved in the podcast and other videos and also get your names in the credits like these handsome devils, then please consider becoming a patron. Links in the description below.